quickly jump into your bed. Quickly cover up your head. Don't you lock the doors, you know the sweet Santa Claus is on the way. Welcome to vlog 47. How have you been? So, on Monday evening, I went along to meet my friend Paul Vale for a very special evening of drinks to celebrate his 20th anniversary working with the stage as one of their leading critics. Now, this is an incredible landmark for Paul, who is one of my favourite critics. He does an incredible job and has always been incredibly supportive and kind of my work and really helped me this year with a lot of advice when I've needed it. It was great to join him for drinks and to really celebrate his achievement. After this, I went along to the Boulevard Theatre for an incredible, intimate cabaret with Nicole Scherzinger. It was remarkable. Now, this is a small theatre that seats 150 people. And there we were with Nicole Scherzinger, up close and personal. I do not know how this came about. How they managed to book her is exceptional. But she was brilliant. She brought along an incredible 12-piece band. And her entire set list was made up of musical theatre. Starting with a song from Kiss of the Spider Woman, she then sang songs from Rent, Hamilton, and her classic Memory from Cats, which I saw her do at the Palladium, which then earned her an Olivier nomination. She is a formidable actress and singer and is stunning. She looks beautiful, honestly. I was in complete awe of her. It was a sensational evening, capped off with a special medley of Pussycat Dolls, and the audience were loving it. Dermot O'Leary, the presenter of X Factor, was even in the audience along with us. On Tuesday, I was at the Wimbledon Theatre for their panto, Cinderella. Starring EastEnders' Samantha Womack, she is superb. Honestly, she just got every beat and made an incredible performance. Starring alongside her as Cinderella was Pussycat Doll and Dancing on Ice star Melody Thornton, who was brilliant and as American really managed to get the sense of panto. The show also had Leslie Garrett, who is an incredible opera singer and legendary, as well as magician Pete Furman playing buttons. My pal Leon Craig was one of the Ugly Sisters, along with Bobby Delaney, and the brilliant Will Jennings played Dandini. And I cannot forget Ed Chittix. Now, Ed is an old pal of mine. We used to go to the gym together, and then he went on to star in Hairspray and On the Town in Regent's Park. He's now grown his hair out to look a bit like a Disney prince and is incredible as Prince Charming. It is a really, really wholesome family show and they do such a good job. And it was also nice to catch up with a few other blogger friends who were in watching the show as well. It's definitely one to take all the family to. On Wednesday, I was at the London Palladium for Goldilocks. The sensational Olivia Award winning panto returned this year with a, well, I won't say all new cast because that's part of the panto's charm. They keep bringing back favourites Paul O'Grady, Julian Clary, Paul Zerdin and Gary Wilmot. It also starred my pal Sophie Isaacs as Goldilocks. And it was incredible to see her on that big stage. Now the brilliant thing about the Palladium's panto is it's more like a variety show. And you cannot get bigger or better than this show. The production values are incredible. The costumes look sensational. The set pieces are brilliant. And they have some incredible variety acts within the show, including four motorcyclists in one of those cages spinning around, two incredible roller skaters, and a fantastic magician. But the star of the show was Matt Baker. The presenter from the One Show is an incredible, incredible acrobat. And build up to him walking across a tightrope. And it is just good, old-fashioned, wholesome entertainment. You were there with him, willing him to succeed as he attempted to walk across the tightrope. And he almost didn't manage, but when he did, the audience were in raptures. Sophie sounded incredible, as did Lauren Stroud, who plays Baby Bear. She is performing alongside her husband, Justin Thomas, was part of the ensemble, and they are such a cute couple. And it's really sweet to see them both performing side by side. Of course, Paul O'Grady and Julian Clary steal the show with their one-liners and comic timing. And it is a really, really well-written show with hilarious one-liners. And Gary Wilmot's solo song, which was essentially a mashup of every West End song you could think of, was brilliant. The Palladium really know what they're doing and really, really get it right. It's a sensational show that is perfect for the entire family, young and old. It really, really delivers. Afterwards, it was nice to catch up with everybody, including Jack Yarrow, who was there as a guest, and as well as Joe McKeldry and the Crankies. Afterwards, I had the most surreal night where I ended up in Freedom Bar with Nicole Scherzinger and Sam Smith. I'm not even joking. It was surreal, but brilliant. And we partied like it was 1999. On Thursday evening, I was back at the cinema to watch Frozen 2 again. I couldn't resist it. It was brilliant. This was after interviewing the cast of Whistle Down the Wind, which I saw last week. I was really excited to meet the cast and get to hear their insight. Here's a section from the video, which you can find on my YouTube channel.
So there are three children, the Bostock children, Kathy, Nan and Charles.
Auntie Dolly's two nieces and one nephew.
They live in a town in Lancashire. Set in the 1950s.
So we are brother and sister, and we have another sister, Nan.
It starts with an evil character called Eddie drowning some kittens. Horrific.
If there was an antagonist, I suppose Raymond would be it.
And we try and go and save the kittens, and Kathy takes them to the barn to hide them.
an old barn on their dad's property.
Kathy, the eldest, finds a man in their barn.
And says, "Who are you?" And he inadvertently says, "Jesus Christ."
And she tells her other two siblings,
"We don't really know who he is. He says he's Jesus and we believe him."
And we all get excited, don't we, the kids, thinking we found Jesus.
They tell all their friends at school.
And eventually all the children in the village discover this man who evidently turns out to possibly be a murderer.
And there's a load of confusion about whether he is him or not.
Panic from all of the local adults, and all of the kids are just loving life with who they think is Jesus.
They keep it secret from the adults and their parents and the town folk.
And that's basically it, but actually he's a crim. And all the adults are like, "Oh my God, there's a criminal around." And the kids are like, "He's Jesus, we got to believe him this time."
And he's this wise, incredible man that they have to protect and follow, and they have to protect him from the adults who will crucify him, because that's what happened last time, when in fact he's actually a murderer.
Yeah.
How funny is it to say it out loud and be like,
"Oh." No, you kind of talk about it and you're like, "Hang on, what am I even saying?" But you have to see it for it to really make sense.
Mm. Later in the evening, I was back at the Boulevard Theatre to watch Emma Hatton's finale cabaret. I love Emma Hatton. I interviewed her earlier in the year when she was in Cats. And she is so lovely. Her cabaret was a very charming evening where she sang a few of her favourite songs and was accompanied by her special guest, Natalie May Paris. Here's one of the songs that they sang together. Friday, I was at the Wembley Park Theatre for a new production of Sleepless. Sleepless is a new musical written based on the film Sleepless in Seattle, which starred Tom Hanks and Meg Ryan. Now, this musical has been tried out a couple of years ago with Danny Mac and has now been brought back with Michael Xavier and Kimberly Walsh. And it's been directed by Morgan Young, who directed Kimberly in Big. Now, the comparisons are very similar. Both Big and Sleepless are adapted from 80s movies. And like Big, I don't think it works. The show felt very dated and very old-fashioned. And I'm not even going to get into the fact that the entire cast were made up of white actors. It just didn't resonate. The music is so archaic and the story outdated that it just limits the possibility of this show ever doing well. And I will be surprised if it does. They've been working on it for the past 3 weeks and presented what they're calling free preview shows at the Wembley Park Theatre, with the intention to mount a full production next year. I mean, I don't really know why they've done it that way or what benefit that will have. And like I say, it remains to be seen whether this show will actually have a life or do well. I wouldn't be in a rush to see it again, and I wouldn't recommend it because it wasn't that good. Plus, the Wembley Park Theatre has only been open for a few months and is a bit of a weird venue. It feels like an arena with stadium-like seating, and it just doesn't feel like a theatre. It's really tricky to explain. It would be probably better suited for pop concerts and gigs than stage shows. Saturday, I went back to watch Anne Juliet again. I can't get enough of this show. I've been listening to the soundtrack over and over again on repeat. And I was lucky enough on Saturday to get to see Grace Myatt, the cover, play Juliet. Now, as much as I love Miriam Teague Lee, she is incredible, it was really interesting to see how Grace was going to tackle the role. Grace, whom most people will know from Six, the musical, trained at GSA, and delivers a completely different interpretation of Juliet. Both Miriam and Grace are fantastic in their own rights, and it is really, really compelling and interesting to see them play them so differently. And Grace is exceptional. Her voice and dancing is superb. And it was really, really enjoyable to watch her do the show. I also sat in the stalls this time, which meant that I got to see more of the set, including the back LED panel, which I didn't notice first time round. Also on Saturday, Oliver Tomsett was ill, which meant I got to see my pal Ivan de Freitas playing Will Shakespeare. And again, he did it in a very different way to Oliver, which made it so enjoyable to watch a new slant on this incredible show that I love. It's one of those shows that I will probably see again and again. And it was great to see that it was practically sold out on Saturday night, which indicates that tickets are selling well. Excellent. Sunday evening, I was at the Upper Palace for a very special concert called This Christmas. Put together by the formidable Alex Parker, it had a collection of superb singers and some of my favourites, including Christina Bennington, Fra Fee, Oliver Sewell, Emma Lindes, Tashan Williams, Evie Rose Lane, and my new favourite, Max Harwood. Like I said before, I saw Max last week in Roles Will Never Play, and he is brilliant. This was an incredible Christmas concert with brand new arrangements of some amazing Christmas songs sang in ways you will not have heard them done before. And they also did a version of Into the Unknown from Frozen 2. I was beside myself. It was brilliant.
Don't want a lot for Christmas. There is just one thing I need. I don't care about the presents underneath the Christmas tree. Oh, I just want you for my own. All I want for Christmas.
I was over at the Trafalgar Studios to see Cinderella. Now, this is a very special version with an all-drag cast and has been put together by Tuckshop. Starring Bag of Chips, who was the runner-up in RuPaul's Drag Race, it's fair to say that it was thrown together very last minute and they've not had a lot of time to put it together. And it showed. It was a bit ropey. Whether that added to the charm or the experience, the audience certainly didn't seem to mind. This was one of 8 sellout shows, which has now been extended by an extra 2 weeks. So if you still want to get a chance to see it, book now for later in January. It was a brilliant and fun show. And like I say, whether through the course of the run, it might get tightened up, I don't know. Or certainly by next year, once these guys know what they're doing, I reckon it could be the start of something really, really special. Because everybody in it was brilliant and quite, quite funny and quite charming. And it's just a nice little concept for a show and really works. At the press night for Curtains, the new West End leg of this touring production, which has already been around the country. This is a fantastic show by the creators of Chicago and Cabaret. And it's so funny. The cast are brilliant, led by Jason Manford, who is superb. I underestimate how good a singer and an actor he is. And in this role, he really, really commands this show. Rebecca Locke, who you might recognise from Heathers, has a brilliant character and is delightful. But it's Samuel Holmes who steals the show with some incredible one-liners. Sam is also working as resident director of this show, so must be knackered because it's such an energetic show to be part of. Also in the show is Andy Coxon, who is looking incredible. And Alan Burkitt caught my eye. He was fantastic. It is a brilliant whodunit set behind the scenes of a Broadway show. And it has some incredible dance numbers and some brilliant songs. I honestly really, really liked it. The after party was held at Planet Hollywood, which was brilliant because we got mini burgers. I loved it. And I also got to chat to Danny Mack, whose wife Carly Stenson is brilliant in this show as well. On Tuesday, I was very kindly given a ticket to the Book of Mormon by a lovely lady called Maz Okogale. I couldn't resist going to see this show again. I love this show and saw it when it first opened here in the West End. And every year I know about 4 or 5 different people in the show. And it's incredible to see them do their thing. My little pal Stevie Webb is currently leading the cast and is superb, alongside Ross Carpenter, Adam Bailey and Sean Parkins, who again I've known for a few years. This show is brilliant. It is hilarious and never fails to disappoint. And it is brilliant every time I see it to see somebody else I know taking on the part, because it's superb. And on Thursday evening, I saw my 370th and final show of the year, West End Does Christmas. And what a show to go out on. This is a series produced by Rob Houchin and his mum, and is always brilliant. They had an incredible cast, which included Frothy, Louise Dearman, Emma Kingston, Craig Mafer, Laura Pilford, and was hosted by Matt Lucas. They didn't really mess around with any of the arrangements. It was just presented as a good, solid, wholesome carol concert. And everybody in the audience was given a little Santa hat to take home with them. It really, really did put everybody in a great festive mood. And everybody on that stage sounded incredible, including the special choir from GSA and the dancers from Erdang. That's it. That was all the shows that I saw in 2019. 370 of them. I am knackered and I'm going to go and have a lie down. Thank you so, so much for watching. Please look out for my special Christmas message where I will be looking back over this incredible year that I've had. Thank you all for watching.